In this video, I'll be showing you how to run a stepper motor using 8051 microcontroller. First, we will go with the bipolar stepper motor. That is something that we are using in our project. So here, we can first observe that this is a bipolar stepper motor. A bipolar stepper motor can be differentiated from a unipolar stepper motor by seeing that there is no center tap from any of the windings. So here there is no center tap and here there is no center tap. So this is a bipolar stepper motor. And whenever you excite one coil, it means that you should excite A and B at the same A, and the return path should be B. And when you excite B, it also means that A is the return path. If B is the sending path, A is the receiving path. A is the sending path, B is the receiving path. The same goes for the second winding too. And we are making a small assumption, and that is whenever I excite A, that is I give a plus supply to A, then we are assuming that the first pole over here, that is the pole that is connected to A, gets a north pole, and the other one here gets a south pole. This is the assumption that we are making, and this here is our rotor. So the thing is that this is expressed as a single permanent magnet, but in reality there are going to be a lot of magnets here which will reduce the which will improve the resolution of the step. So the common steps being 1.8 degrees and 7.2 degrees. So that is about it. So we are going to excite this windings over here using a H-bridge driver. So one very popular H-bridge driver is the L293D. So we probably will be using that, or we have actually used that. So that is one thing. And I also want you to keep an eye on the table over here. This is the A, this is the C, D, B and D, and that is the excitation for each one shown here. Whenever I show a 1 here, that means we are giving a plus VCC to this, and the B here is being given 0, while this winding here is inactive. So that's about it. So first we will give it a positive supply. So this is about it, and then you can see that this is a north and this is the south. This has been, the red implies a plus VCC, the black implies a return or a DC neutral. So the force will be in this direction, okay, and so the rotor will try to rotate like this. So it has made a step of 90 degrees. So that's about it. So then we excite C and D, where C is given the plus VCC and D is given the minus DC neutral, or the DC neutral, and you can observe that C has been given 1. So then this is the situation, this is the force, and yes, we are there. So, and this is the same thing that will be applied, that can be applied to all the other states too. So this is the third one, and this is the last one. So that's about it. So now, if you want to reverse the operation of the motor, you can do it in the reverse operation. So that will reverse the motor. So this is about it. But this method is called the half wave stepping. And the problem, the main and the major problem with this is that the rotor. So if you can see, the field is always making a transition of 90 degrees mechanically. So from here it is coming to this place, and that is the change in the angle is 90 degrees for the field. And when this happens, the rotor is being subjected to a sudden change in the field direction, and it has to keep up with that. But because the rotor is mechanically speaking a cylinder, and it has a certain moment of inertia, in a few cases it might not be able to catch up with the speed of rotation of the stator field. So that is a problem. So when is this a problem? Well, the fact that if the field transition is super fast, if the field transition is super fast, then it means that the rotor may not be able to catch up with the speed of the rotor, speed of the stator flux. But if the speed of rotation of the stator flux is slow, then the rotor has no problem. So that's about it. So 900 milliseconds delay, that is, this is excited for 900 milliseconds, and then this is excited for 900 milliseconds, this one and this one. If that is 900 milliseconds, probably the rotor will not have a problem. But if this is 900 microseconds, then there will be a problem. And also, whenever you want to suddenly increase the speed of rotation of the motor, then also there will be a problem. And that is, for example, you are transitioning from one state to other state in 900 milliseconds, and then suddenly you give it a delay that makes the transition from to a 500 millisecond microsecond or something like that. Then the change in the delay is huge. So this will actually cause the rotor to lose synchronism with the stator flux. So that's a problem. So how do we solve this problem? Well, there is full wave stepping. Well, in full wave stepping, we increase the number of steps. So let us first assume that this red line here is the reference axis, and the rotor is aligned in this direction. So this is the south and this is the north. Now in this full wave stepping, we will be exciting D for some time, and then we will excite D and A, in this situation, in full wave stepping, you will be exciting one coil at one point of time, and then you will be exciting both the coils at the same time. So this will improve the resolution angle of rotation, so of the stator flux. So that's how you can make the motion less jerky. And I also want you to keep an eye on this table over here. This pointer will be representing the state we are presently in. So first here we are going to excite D. That is, we are going to give it a plus positive plus supply, and C will be given a negative supply while A and B will be inactive. So this is the situation. Those will be the forces, and thus the rotor rotates. Now this now is going to be the next important case. Here, if you can see, A and D are being given this positive supplies. So this will be a north, C. This will be a north, this will be a north, this will be a south, this will be a south. So the resultant flux vector will be in this direction. So that's it. Now, if this is in this direction, the rotor will try to align in that direction, because a magnet always tries to maintain minimum reluctance path. I should have mentioned this earlier. This is the most important aspect of any stepper motor. So this is about it. So yes, we are there. Then this. So now we are going to excite the other two. Yes, we are there. And then yes, the next step, which is going to excite A and C at the same time. So that's about it. Yes, and this is how the rotation should be. So if you want to reverse the rotation of the motor, as explained earlier, you should be reversing the sequence. So that's about it. How the code looks. Well, I'm using a Keel Microvision software to program the 8051 microcontroller, and I am using embedded C to code the 8051 source code. So I have an onboard compiler which can cross compile and debug, so I have no problem with that. So firstly, I am going to declare register 52.h, which has all the names for the identifiers, and stdio.h
for some standard functions. Now I'm also declaring SBET, which is switch 3.7 pin on the board. They have given me a hardwired switch over there to the pin number 7 on port 3, so I'm directly using that. And then there is an integer variable t which decides which mode we are currently working in. And then there is the prototype for the void delay function. So now you can also see, so we are going to enter into the void main, and we have initiated a do while loop. And here the situation is simple. If the switch becomes low, then we are going to introduce a delay of 1000, and this is very important because if this is not there, the system the switch will bounce and will cause a lot of spurious signals. So we are giving the processor enough time to neglect the bouncing in the switch, so that is very important. So that is why this delay is here. So we are giving it almost 1000 milliseconds of delay. And then there is going to be the switch case function, switch case statement, where for every case we have written what should be the next case, and that is if the initial case is 0, then the next case is 1. If the initial case is 1, then the next case is 2. If the initial case is 2, then this is 3, then bring it back to 0. And also I have introduced a default which is also equal to 0. So this is the situation that we are talking about right now. And if you can also see, t is equal to 0 corresponds to half wave stepping with 5 millisecond delay, and t is equal to 1 corresponds to reversed half wave stepping with 5 millisecond delay, and t is equal to 2 corresponds to half wave stepping delay at 1 millisecond, and the last one, that is t is equal to 3, corresponds to full wave stepping at 1 millisecond. So these are the four cases that we'll be talking about in our situation. So see that this is going to be the first thing that you are going to write in every case. So if t is equal to 0 implies that whenever t is equal to 0, this whole code will be activated until t is equal to 0. Until and unless we press the switch, this won't change, and if that changes, then the next one will be activated. And these are the opcodes that we are going to write. These are the codes that we are going to write which help in motoring. And also this is the declaration used to light up the LED. So here you can also see that these codes that I have written, 0x01, 0x04, 0x02 and 0x08, are the codes that are used to fire the appropriate switch in the hedge bridge in the L293D motor driver. And this, if repeated, will cause the motor to rotate. So that's about it. And each state will be active for 5 milliseconds. So that is what this says. And then this is the second case, that is reverse half wave stepping. And as we have discussed earlier, 0428 should be reversed to 8241. So you can see 8241 is the sequence, so the motor should reverse. Then I have, in the next case, I have done nothing but decreasing the delay and keeping the sequence same, that is for forward stepping 1428. Nothing else has changed. But in this case, as we have discussed, I have increased the number of states to 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So there are completely 8 states, and each will correspond to a particular firing scheme for the hedge bridge, and it will help in full wave stepping. So that's about it. And this is enclosed in a while, and this one implies an infinitive loop. So this whole thing will be rotating for an indefinite time, and this will be on until the microcontroller is powered on. And this is the function declaration. So here you can see this is the subroutine that we are talking about. So void delay int, so it is receiving an integer type data, and it is actually wasting processor time to create the delay that we were talking about. So if you have any doubts, look up any book that deals with, look into any book that will deal with embedded computing, so you can easily understand how to work with this stuff. Actually, I was also thinking about implementing an interrupt service routine, but this is working fine, so I let it be this way because I'm not using a lot of processor time and there are no stipulations, so this is working fine for me. So let's see how this actually works in the real time. So now we are going to run the stepper motor. This is a bipolar stepper motor, and this is the wheel that has been connected to it. And these four are the field winding wires, and those have been connected to the L293D motor driver. And these two are the gating pins, and those gating pins are controlled by the 8051 microcontroller by the code that we have talked about. And this is the basic shield, which is going to say which mode we presently are working in. If the first LED is on, then it means that we are in the half-wave stepping mode with a delay of 5 milliseconds. If the second LED is on, then it means that we are in the reversed half-wave stepping mode with the same delay of 5 milliseconds. The third is a 1 millisecond delay half-wave stepping, and the fourth is a full-wave stepping at 1 millisecond. So now we are going to run for each mode. So I'm going to switch on the supply, and you can see that the motor is rotating, and we presently are in the first mode. Now when I press this switch again, this is going to reverse the direction. So the direction has reversed, and this is in half wave stepping mode and with a delay of 5 milliseconds. And then is the next special case, and this is the case where the half wave stepping fails. That is, if the speed of rotation of the field is so fast that the rotor is not able to catch up with the field. So you can see that even though we are in the third mode, the rotor is not rotating because it is not able to catch up with the speed of the rotation of the stator flux. And the last mode, you can see that even though the delay is 1 millisecond, and even though the field transition is as fast as the previous case, the rotor is still able to catch up with the speed of the stator, and that is because it is in the full wave stepping mode. So I will summarize again. So this is the first half wave stepping mode, and you can see that the speed is small when compared to the fourth case. And this is the reverse step half wave stepping, same specifications. And then this is the mode where the rotor stalls, and the last mode where the rotor does not stall even though the delay is 1 millisecond and even though the speed of rotation of the stator flux is as fast as the third case, but still the rotor is able to catch up with the speed